faktisk en rigtig stor fornøjelse, at vi nu i aften skal have en kåring. Ja, vi skal faktisk ikke bare have en kåring. Vi skal sige farvel, men bestemt forhåbentlig på gensyn. Sidste år havde vi på Pirates hold en spiller, der på ryggen var tallet 91. Han gjorde det så godt, at en af de sidste ting, vi har i slutspillet, siger Jimmy Møjgaard, hver gang unge Jonathan Brinkmann, han er på isen, så er det en sand investering i hele dansk ishockey. Og nu skal Jonathan overprøve kræfter over der. Han skal en tur til Canada og være holdkammerat til Mads Søgaard på Madison Hat Tigers. Ikke længe vil vi gerne sige en rigtig god rejse til Jonathan. Men hvad Jonathan ikke ved, er at han skal ind til direktør Thomas Bjuring. Han har en lille skifteramme, og på den kan vi nu afsløre, at Jonathan Brinkmann sidste år er kåret til årets unge talent i hele metalligaen. Og det er en kæmpe fornøjelse, når unge pirater, de kan slippe afsted med at trække så store priser ind, og vi er rigtig glade. Når vi vil sætte det videre til det store udland, Jonathan, rigtig god fornøjelse.
Garth Murray, your second preseason match, you lost 3-2 against Sønderjyske. Put your words on the game.
It wasn't our best game, without a doubt. Obviously see some rust in our systems. They came out very hard and we just weren't prepared for that. Maybe we had some junk in our legs from, we had a big team building event yesterday. So maybe that's a bit of a hangover from that. But I thought we came back a bit better in the second, and the third was kind of back and forth. So we responded good, but the Sunnies came out hard. So that's something that's going to happen throughout the year. So we need to learn how to handle that and make better plays, better breakouts.
The first two periods, you were leading 1-0, but then Sønderjyske came back and scored two goals, and then you seemed a little bit shaky at that period in the third period.
It was two goals off transition, which when you're holding the lead, you should have a mindset of holding that. We got some forwards up in the play a bit too much, and then broke down in our neutral zone. So that's something that that's stuff we're still working on day by day here in training. So it's it's good to get some video on it. We can correct it, go over it as a team, and then see where the mistakes and the breakdowns happen and where we need to be in certain situations. But I thought they transitioned really well against us tonight. So I'll look back, at the neutral zone pretty tight this afternoon.
And your players, they have to realize that it doesn't come easy. You have to work hard every game.
Oh, without a doubt, that's how it is. We got a lot of guys with good work ethic. I thought we got some good offensive pressure there. They're a good defensive team with good structure, so we're able to do some stuff offensively when we got it in there. But puck management and just getting better breakouts to relieve that pressure is going to be very big against that team throughout the year. And that stuff we'll be working on pretty much every day here.
What do you think about your power play and your penalty killing?
The PK did a pretty good job tonight, I thought. 4-on-3, they got one at the end there, hit a seam pass on us. Didn't have the right alignment. That's stuff that we work on. We got a month in training camp, so that's stuff we work on throughout the course of things here. So we got to get a few more things where we want to be, a little more information for the players so we know what to do in certain situations there. But the PK was good. The power play had some good opportunities as well, but that's something that we got to get going as well. We're able to get a goal on the 5-on-3 there to tie it up late, which is always nice. That'll be a focus, obviously, in practice on Thursday.
Thanks.
Thanks, Pierre.